At that time in our heads that Eric Idle's after here for a world record, it's 114.99. 98 then for the world record.
See what they come across at the 600 meter mark. He has a very good chance. If he keeps up the same pace, he could end up on a 114.
Eric Idle skating through the fine snow of the Bavarian Alps late on this Sunday afternoon. Same day coverage by satellite.
Again, if nothing happens at this point, he could be on a world record.
Because we had the problem yesterday. Well, a little bit, but not as bad as yesterday. Remember, again, the time is 1:14.98. He needs for the world record. And it's 1:15.07. Didn't do it. But there, once again, is a good look at the style, at least, of, again, the world sprint speed skating champion, Eric Idle of Wisconsin. This next pair will decide who's going to finish second and third here, with Boucher already having skated. Here we have Pete Muller of the United States going against Frode Runing of Norway. Now, Runing is in third place. Muller is in fourth. In order to beat out Boucher, Runing would need a 1:16.99. Muller would need a 1:15.63. And, of course, there's a personal battle between the two of them here for a possible bronze medal. And it's Pete Muller on the outside.
They both got a really good start. You see, Pete, he gets down so low, as opposed to Roning, who's a little bit taller. He stands up a little bit higher.
Okay, Pete Muller had the faster start time by 0.07 of a second, but he's got to beat Frode Runing by better than 1.5 seconds in order to pass him. There, the coach is giving their signals as to how the men are doing.
Pete Muller's been training on his own this year, but Diane Holum, who's the coach of Beth Hyden and Eric Hyden, is giving him his lap times.
Okay, on the right, that is the man who won the gold medal in the Olympic Games at Innsbruck, Austria, 1976.
He's ahead of Froning at this point.
Yes, he is. That's Pete's time on the left, 46.03. He's got to beat him by quite a bit, however, in order to move ahead of him.
Diane's giving him the fingers, the down, which means that he's ahead of his schedule, so you know that he's really trying to beat Froning to move up in his position.
Okay, Pete Muller trying to pour it on. Gee, he looks so much better than he did last year.
He's really trained hard this year. He's trying to make a better comeback.
His time, 1:16.95. Not good enough to beat out Boucher, and I don't believe good enough to beat out Roning. And so the final standings. Haydn, Boucher, and Roning for the medals. Pete Muller narrowly missing the bronze. By the way, Dan Immerfall and Tom Plant of the United States were 8th and 10th, an outstanding showing by the American men. And both championships today are won by the United States. This is Jim McKay with Sheila Young-Akowitz by satellite from Insel. Now on to the Winter National Drag Racing Championships and Keith Jackson.
This is what